Hi, welcome to Onyx Food Hill. Here in this video, I'm going to be showing you a very fast and easy tips on how to fry fish with flour. If you are new to this channel, please subscribe. And if you have already subscribed, welcome back. So I have some fish which I'm going to be using. This is mackerel. You can use any type of fish. And I've already prepared my marinade. So here I have blended onions, pepper, garlic, ginger, and thyme. So you can make your choice of marinade. And then I have here blend flour. You can use corn flour for this recipe. So I'm going to be combining the blended onions, garlic, ginger, which I have blended into the flour. Then I'll add a little water. I've also added salt and one seasoning cube to this mixture. So I'm not going to make this watery, just a moderate paste. That's what I want to make right away. So the first thing you have to note before frying fish: if your fish is frozen, you have to make sure you remove it from the fridge and keep for about an hour or overnight for the fish to thaw very well and for the water to separate from the fish. And also you can use paper towel to dry your fish. So I have dried mine already. So after mixing my flour, I'm going to marinate the fish in it. Just mix the fish. Can use your hands to rub the batter all over the fish. After dipping the fish in the batter, you can keep this aside into another bowl and do the rest. I'm going to make sure the marinade goes into the fish very well. Ginger and garlic is very good for seasoning fish. They add a very nice taste to the fish. So after doing this, I'm still going to keep this aside and also do the next. So this is what I'm going to do with the remaining fish. The quantity of your marinade depends on the quantity of fish you are going to be frying. It is also very important to marinate your fish before frying them. So make sure you marinate your fish with your preferred seasoning before you start frying them. So garlic and ginger are very important for marinating fish. So I think you should use that whenever you want to marinate your fish. So once I am done, I'll set this aside for just about 2 minutes. The next thing we are going to do is to start frying the fish right away. So you have to heat up vegetable oil on and allow it to get hot very well. The oil you're going to be using for the fish, it should not be too small and it shouldn't be too much. That should depend on the quantity of fish you're going to be frying. And also you must allow the oil to get very hot before adding in the fish, so that the fish don't get soaked in the oil and at the end of the day scattered or break down. Okay, so once the oil is hot, you can start adding in the fish. You have to be careful. You have to be frying each side
thickening it on each side. So we want to make sure the fish doesn't break down in the oil. Once the fish is brown on one side, you can turn over to the next side and fry also. So our aim is to fry the fish without it breaking in the oil. So this is very easy and very fast also. So once I have flipped over to the next side, I'm still going to allow this to fry for 2 minutes or 1 minute, let's say. So once both sides are fried and they are brown, so I'm going to drain this in a colander. You can use paper towel to drain this. So always make sure you don't fry your fish on a low heat. If not, it will soak up oil. Let it be on a medium heat, like what you're seeing right here. Now we are done. If you notice, the oil is not filled with the fish marinade because I had to make it into a paste so that it doesn't cover the oil. So you can see the oil is still very neat, just few of the marinade that just dropped, and that's all. So this was how to fry fish. This was a very simple way to fry fish without it breaking. Okay, so you can enjoy the fish with fried rice, jollof rice, or any kind of rice. You can enjoy your fish the way it is with lime. Thanks for watching. Bye.